Hello, everybody, and welcome to Gambling Goals. I am your host, Mitch Carr. You can find me on Twitter, at Mitch Carr TV. And the man you came to see, the man with the plan, the man with all the picks, he is Prospector Sam. You can find him on Twitter, at Prospector underscore Sam. And before we get into the football, we're going to talk about football, because I have it on here that Prospector Sam is a college football genius. Turns out he's an all football genius, because he went 7-1 on college picks over the weekend, 5-1 on pro picks. So, Sam, you picked soccer very well, but apparently anything that is called football where a ball is kicked, you're pretty good at that.
You know, sometimes it's about getting a couple good bounces. We definitely got a couple of those over the weekend, but you don't have weeks like that very often. And it was a lot of fun. I had a lot of people around Twitter and other places who made some money. And that's really at the end of the day what we want. You know, if it's gambling goals in soccer or whatever it is, you know, I write these articles and do these videos for fun. And it was great to see people making some money. And, you know, let's just keep that rolling and do it in soccer this week. I think we got some great picks that'll hopefully come out on the right end of the stick, and we can make some money together. So let's fucking do it.
Yeah. Hey, gambling goals, where the goal is to make you money. Gosh, it only took me 20 episodes to come up with a tagline like that, but that's pretty good, right? Okay.
No, you're so clever. You're so clever.
Oh, man. That's why they pay me nothing to do this show. Okay. We're going to get into the soccer picks. Sam is right at 500 on the season, 15-15-1. He's in a little bit of a downswing, but we're coming off of an international break, and he's coming off a hot streak in another sport. So I'm sure that will translate. Right, Sam?
I mean, hey, you know, it was a little bit of a lull. We took a week off for personal reasons.
For Vegas vacation.
and then we took a week off for some international soccer. So we've cleared our heads. We're ready. We're back. You know, looked around the board. I actually picked a few less games this week. I'm trying to really streamline and kind of get the best of the best in there and leave out some of the fluff. So hopefully these ones are all winners. I'm not going to say they're definitely winners, but I feel great about all these picks.
What are you talking about? Of course they're winners. That's why we do the show. You're not giving losers. I'm not here hosting a show with someone giving out losers.
You're right. It's not really gambling. That's not what we do here. It's all about right and wrong and yes and no. So you know what? Fine. Fuck it. They're all winners. Every single one of them. In my head right now, they are. Like I can walk you through why all eight of these games should be right. And I feel like they are. So we'll see.
Well, let's dive right in. We're going to start with the English Premier League. A London derby, because they're all London derbies, because half the teams in the Premier League are from London these days. Brentford and Chelsea. What do you like here?
Yeah, I wrote about this in the article. And sometimes, you know, you don't need to be too clever when you gamble. And that's the pick here. It doesn't take too much to see Chelsea money line. But at the end of the day, you know, sometimes it's about getting the right value. About seeing the right pick, and at minus 160 for Chelsea to win this game, you're kind of getting, you know, a steal. You know, as the saying goes in soccer, you know, form is temporary, class is permanent. Brentford are in some great form. They've done well to start the season. They're in sixth place. Guess what? They just don't have a single player on their team that can make Chelsea starting lineup. Chelsea are just a far better team. Yeah, no, that's a fact. I don't even think it's disputable. They're just a far better team. Chelsea, even on the road, even coming off a break where most of their players are going to be coming off international duty and none of Brentford's are, they just are going to be a better team. If they come out, play even halfway close to as good as they can, they win this game. Brentford still aren't scoring very well, and against Chelsea, that's going to be a huge problem. Lukaku is going to dominate them on the other side of the field. Minus 160 on the money line. It's great value. It's actually better value than I wrote about in the article. I had it at a minus 170, so you know, I think that's great. I would hammer this one. I think they win this game comfortably.
Now, that is an interesting thing you bring up, though. You're going to have Chelsea players who are coming off international breaks where they played. There's not a lot of Brentford players that played. They did draw with Liverpool, which was very impressive. But I do agree with you. At some point, the shine is going to wear off Brentford, right? They start the season with a home win against Arsenal. That was impressive. And then they get a draw with Liverpool, who's top of the table or almost close to it. Chelsea is top of the table, so we'll see if they can keep their form going. But as a newly promoted side, I agree with you. It's going to have to fall off. And against a team like Chelsea that defends so well, it would make a lot of sense if it falls off here. Staying in London now, Tottenham hosting Newcastle. That game is on Sunday. Newcastle, the newly minted human rights villain of the league. That means the heat is off of us, Manchester City. Woohoo!
Yeah, don't get too excited. You know, being the second worst is not, you know, not a win. It's just a slightly less bad loss. I couldn't avoid this game partially because of that. You know, the news is so big that you have to talk about it a little. It's going to be gross seeing this team be good. They're going to be pumping money in it. Like you have no, I mean, they're the owners of the team now are what, $45 billion net worth, which is like 10 times.
It's a bottomless pit of oil and money.
Yeah. So, I mean, you know, it's just going to be disgusting. You're going to feel dirty about it. Nobody wants to see Newcastle win. They're in the middle of goddamn nowhere. The weather sucks. It's going
to
be.
I actually wonder who's going to want to go there. And I don't know if people thought that nobody would want to go to Manchester, but Manchester United had already proven that you can really build a dynasty in the city of Manchester. So clearly somebody was willing to go there. Like, they were talking about Raheem Sterling possibly being transferred to Newcastle. Raheem Sterling would rather play for Real Madrid. I don't think he wants to go to Newcastle.
Yeah, well, Real Madrid can't afford anything anymore because they're so far in debt that they're fucked. But
because they're trying to keep up with the PSGs and the Man Cities of the world.
Yeah, and now the Newcastles of the world. So
now the Newcastles of the world.
So yeah, unfortunately, Newcastle are going to be good for a while. It's not great news for the Tottenhams of the world who are, you know, struggling and fighting an uphill battle. Not that we really have much hope, anyways. But I like this game here because as of now, Newcastle are still fucking terrible. They've given up 16 goals in 8 games to start the year. They're in 18th place. This team is just not very good. They have no talent other than Saint-Maximin, which means you basically just have to tag down him. I think, you know, coming off an international break, Nuno's going to have a plan for that. Højbjerg is probably the guy that's going to tail him, you know, kind of cause problems for him on the defensive end. And then offensively, I mean, there's just too much talent. This Newcastle team can't stop anyone from scoring. You know, hopefully I say this with, you know, some veiled optimism, about Tottenham actually being good because I learned my lesson so many times, about having optimism and then getting crushed, but I do think they win this game. They're the better team, at plus 110 on this money line too. You're getting good value. I mean, Newcastle are just a very bad side right now until they get, you know, an entirely new back line. They're going to struggle to beat anyone that's got, you know, a decent offensive performance. And I think Tottenham are just a better team. They should win this game. Plus 110 is good value for a team that is at the very least a top 10 team in the league. And I think they win this game. Plus 110, I think this is a very solid bet.
Now, like Dunkirk in reverse, we're going to cross the English Channel to Ligue 1. Troyes, another City Football Group special against Nice on Sunday. What do you like here?
Yeah, we're back in Nice. You know, we've been here before, and we're going back for another bite of the apple. This line makes about as much sense as I don't have a good anecdote here because I wasn't prepared for it. But it makes about zero fucking sense. A flamingo in a, you know, a bathtub, whatever. Something that, yeah, no, we'll see. I don't know what I'm going with.
Now, that is a unique analogy I've never heard. You know why I've never heard of it? Because it doesn't make any sense.
It doesn't make a goddamn sense.
How about a flamingo
sense?
In a snowstorm?
Yeah, sure. We'll go with that one too. But this line doesn't make any sense to me. Nice are actually, you know, probably the best team in Ligue 1 right now. They have a plus.
Hold up. Really? The best team?
They are playing like they are second in the league and playing like possibly the best team. They've got a plus 17 goal difference with, I think it's like 20 goals or plus 13 goal difference, something crazy. You know, I'm forgetting the stat now, but they've given up 4 goals and I think it scored like 17 or 18 in 7 games. They're in second place, which for a team like this, you know, they're not expected to really finish that high in the league. They'll probably regress back to somewhere around fifth or eighth, you know, fifth, 5 to 8, which for them is still a fairly good finish. And the real value here is that Troyes is pretty terrible. They've got 6 points through 9 games. They really have shown, you know, since getting promoted that they're just not ready for this. They're not a good enough team to compete in Ligue 1. And, you know, against a team, again, Nice is not, you know, as good as they're showing right now. They're probably a little bit less good, but they're still a far better team than Troyes. You know, I don't think that Troyes really is going to keep up in this game, you know, in terms of form, in terms of quality. Everything points towards Nice winning this game. You're basically getting a coin flip in the odds for them to win, even on the road. I think that this is great value. It's 16 versus number 2 in the league. Just feels like one where you need to take a swing, and kind of the odds are a little skewed by Nice not having quite as big of a name as some of the other sides you see in Ligue 1. So I like this one a lot. I think it's got a ton of value.
Bold to say they're the best team in Ligue 1. You might be right. Lille did win the league. PSG didn't win it last
playing
year.
Playing the best in Ligue
1. This might be the year that Nice is better than PSG. Who knows?
Yeah, well, hopefully.
All right. Now, he just couldn't resist. You thought he was going to stick with the biggest leagues and the Champions League teams, but no. We're going to go to the Swiss Super League now for Sion? Which part of Switzerland is it? Is it in the part where they speak French or German or Hungarian? I don't know. Sion versus FC Basel. That one I know how to say. For one,
you left out a C. It's Sion with the C. So.
Oh, no. Yeah, we've got a typo.
Shame on you. Those poor bastards are, you know, getting left out and disparaged by Mitch Carr and gambling goals. I'm sure they're very upset.
Let me just tell you that gambling goals regrets the error.
Yeah, we do. And if this is streaming anywhere in Switzerland at any point in time, one, we're terribly sorry. You are in the wrong place. You should be somewhere else. Two, we will spell it correctly next time.
Send chocolate.
Oh, yeah, and send chocolate, too. Or have us out, you know.
Or a little clock.
Oh, my God. We'd go out and do some live shows from Switzerland. I've never been. It sounds awesome.
Live shows from Switzerland. Yeah, let's maybe let's meet each other in person first.
No. Live shows. What better than a trip together to get to know each other, right?
I have some ex-girlfriends that said the same thing.
we're getting weird today. So how's the game? Basel is about -130 on the money line right now, just to skip ahead, -135 as far as Mitch's most recent lines. And quite honestly, that's great value here. I mean, Basel have just beaten the bejesus out of every team in the Super League, not named Young Boys. They're just much better. They play, you know, European soccer every year. They can recruit and bring in players that are just a higher quality than most teams. Sion, you know, are a team that finished regularly in the bottom half of the Super League. They're just not all that good. They have a -10 goal difference, I believe, through 9 games. That's not exactly impressive, and they're coming up against the highest goal scoring team in the Super League. Basel money line just feels like an easy winner here. Again, you've got the challenge of a few more of the Basel players becoming off international break and actually having played in that. But again, the quality, the talent disparity here is just too much. I think they win this game. I think they win it probably comfortably, to be honest. I think this line is probably the best one we have on the show. I think the value is great. And I would have expected it closer to the -200 number. So -135, -130. Absolutely love it. I would hammer this bet.
All right, so he's got 4 picks for you this week, and we're going to go back to the English Premier League. We start with Brentford and Chelsea, a London derby. He likes the Chelsea money line. That's 160 right now, and that is according to Bovada, all of these lines are. Back in the EPL, he's got Tottenham and Newcastle. He likes the Tottenham money line. That one is positive odds there, +110 for Tottenham. Go Spurs. To Ligue 1, Troyes and Nice. He likes the Nice money line. That is at -115 as of right now. And to the Swiss Super League, Bovada spells it Sion. So I don't know what you're talking about, man. We might have some Swiss people
maybe,
coming.
Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I just went on a 2-minute rant that wasn't correct, and I'm going to look real bad. I was pretty sure. I wrote my article today, and I'm pretty sure I went and double-checked this. So you know what, let me find out right now before.
Bovada just has it spelled Sion, so well, I don't really know what to do.
I think Bovada would not be the one I trust.
Fair.
Oh my God, it is Sion. Jesus Christ!
Boom! Guess who's the Jesus host? Right. For a darn good reason. That's right.
Is there some spelling of this that has a C? Am I just making this up in my brain?
But there's a C in FC Basel.
Fine. You know what? Whatever.
You don't have to know how to spell them or pronounce them in order to pick them, or in this case, pick against them. So in this case, the pick is FC Basel, money line, -135. It is money line madness here on Gambling Goals, where again, the goal is to make you money. We appreciate you watching. I am your host, Mitch Carr. You can find me on Twitter at Mitch Carr TV, and he is Prospector Sam. You can find him on Twitter at Prospector_Sam. You can go to dimers.com for more of his picks in soccer as well as in football. You're going to want to follow him either way because he is dominating right now.
And, but don't that's it. Spelling advice. Do not come for spelling advice.
Spelling. Definitely don't come to me for pronunciation, even though I try. But definitely do come for gambling and making money. We appreciate you watching, and we'll see you next week.